Mummy, how much salt to put in this curry? I was in the midst of a cooking come education session. Add salt to taste. Salt to taste? What does that mean? How many spoons? Yes, salt to taste. You see, every curry has different salt requirements. Not only does it depend on the quantity of the curry, it also depends on the curry itself. You should be able to bring out the taste of other more subtle ingredients. So how many spoons for this paneer butter masala? The typical procedure is to first add some salt, then validate, adjust, and then repeat. Always remember, nobody likes an over-salted dish, but to an under-salted one, you can always add more. Toastmasters and guests, indeed, nobody likes an over-salted dish. Who knew, who could understand it better that day than me? Nobody ate my paneer butter masala. Eventually, we ended up going out for dinner. But this phrase, add salt to taste, remained ingrained in my brain forever. Cut to 2 years later, I was in the midst of a storm. It was my board examinations. Now, unless you flunked the 12th standard, you must have witnessed this great Indian education circus. The overwhelming pressure to score more than Sarmaji's son, together with CBSE's horrifying questions and retests, does indeed take a heavy toll on you. So here I was in the examination hall, writing om and drawing margins on top of every page. The invigilator hands me the question paper. I see everyone stepping their foot on the accelerator. But my scooter, it had no petrol. Just when things started seeming gloomy, I had a eureka moment. I had to add salt, that is right answers, to questions, that is the dishes. The quantity of salt depended on the maximum marks laid out for the question. Okay, so how do you go about it? It's pretty simple. You first write some answer, then you validate with the maximum marks, you adjust and repeat. So I began. Question 1. Which places in India are famous for tea? How many marks? 1 mark. Assam. Next question. Which places in India grow iron ore? How many marks? 5 marks. India is a rich country with geographical location suited for a wide variety of mineral resources. One such is iron ore. Add salt to taste. Not only did I do well, I was also able to score more than Sarmaji's son. I could overhear him. You are good for nothing. Look at Kediaji's son, he scored 2 marks more than you. Relationships. I must admit, I am a mess dealing with people. Raise your hands if you have an emotional mom. Put them all together. It still will be insufficient for my mom. She tells me one day, son, it looks like all my children have inherited the traits of their father. Arrogance, carelessness, no time for me. I tell myself, the recipe lacks salt. So I start increasing salt. I start giving her more time, more care. Call her 3-4 times a day. Few days later, she tells me, son, looks like all my children have inherited the traits of their bua. Constant nagging and disturbance. Totally uncomfortable. Oops. Recipe gone over salted. I reduce my encroachment. Life sorted. Toastmasters and guests, uniqueness and imperfection are omnipresent in every facet of our life, isn't it? Every aspect of our life is different from every other. Each of them requires different amount of salt to bring out the taste of other more subtle ingredients. The quantity of salt needed in your relationship with your mother is very different from what is needed with your girlfriend. And it is very, very different from what is needed when you are reading a book or playing football, or for that matter, escorting your children to school. Also, as humans, we tend to be imperfect in dealing with these situations. So how do we make this imperfection tend to zero? We embark on an iterative process. We first add some salt, we then validate, adjust, and repeat. Remember, you are the chef of your dishes. You can either make it awesome or ruin it. So the next time you talk to your son, the next time you write a piece of code, remember, add salt to taste. A beautiful dish awaits you. Thank you.